We're delighted to be here. We're going to play four pieces for you. The first one is from one of the famous Johann Sebastian Bach's sons, Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach, who, let's see, wait a minute.
Yeah.
After Bach and Handel died, they had built music, the Baroque period, to such a height that the taste in music took a right 90 degrees and changed to mostly homophony from polyphony, is where everybody, you think of the Messiah and all those hallelujahs going on at once. They went to homophony with melody, clear melody with accompaniment. And that, it's called the Rococo period, it's before Mozart. And Mozart and Haydn and those guys developed it in the classical period. So this is one of those men we don't hear a lot about, who thought his dad was old-fashioned, didn't write music in the modern style anymore. He didn't, because he was dead. He died in 1750, and that was the end of his writing. And so this new style came along. We're going to play a movement of Carl C.P.E. Bach's Third Symphony in C. The next piece is Paul's Chaconne for After a Storm. A chaconne is a very, very old musical form, usually it was a dance in three, some kind of triple meter. Everybody wrote chaconne, Vivaldi, Bach. This is written by a young man who is alive now, who is writing, wants to be a Hollywood film musician, okay? And he was a graduate of the Chamber Orchestra in Salt Lake. He was the State Sterling Scholar in Music in Utah. His name's Chad Cannon, and he wrote this. I have to read this to you because I can't, it's just better that way. To me, the chaconne, a piece built on repeated harmonic progressions, is a powerful form because of its resemblance to nature itself, with its continuous cycles, seasonal changes, the Earth's daily rotations, and so forth. This chaconne in particular embodies the hopeful thought that storms, while often brutal, are only temporary occurrences. As it happened, the week I completed this piece, millions in the Philippines were in the path of one of the largest storms in history, Typhoon Haiyan. I pray for their speedy recovery and mourn for the loss of life in such a wonderful nation. It is my hope that this music will speak peace to those who have endured loss.
Thank you.
Our third piece is a multi-section piece. It's a theme and variations based on the theme is written by Tchaikovsky, and you will hear it introduced at the very beginning in the violins. And then Arinsky, who was an admirer of Tchaikovsky, both Russians, of course. Arinsky's not known too much to the Western world, but he's certainly known in Russia as a great musician. Well, he took then 9 variations of different styles and different speeds, and somewhere in each one of those variations, you will hear Tchaikovsky's theme. After the 9 variations, if you're counting, okay, if you count, I don't care if you count or not, just enjoy the music. But the music will stop, and then there will be a really unusual sound, and that is the beginning of the coda, which marks the end of the piece. It's a very lovely piece. Richard requested that we do it. It is very difficult for young people of this age to do. Not because it's extremely technical, but because it calls on emotional needs that many of them are not grown into yet. Okay? Thank heavens for that. But they still play it beautifully. So these are the Arinsky variations on a theme of Tchaikovsky.
Take a second and tell him which repeats we don't do. most of it.
Also a multi-section work, but we're only going to play the first and last movements. The first movement is called Preludio, and the last movement is called Fugue. It's by Ernst Bloch, who during the Nazi takeover in Germany, he and his parents fled Germany, went to Switzerland, and eventually found their way to America, where he wrote a lot of his music. He was of Jewish heritage, and a lot of his music bespeaks that heritage. This is not one of those pieces, but this is a piece written in modern harmony in old style. It's like putting new wine in old bottles, okay? The Preludio is really different, and it has a mixed meter, which means it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, any which way, okay? And then, and we have the blessing of having Lita Grossman on the piano. It's 4 strings and piano solo, although it's not a piano concerto. She's part of the team. The last movement is a fugue, the same way that Bach would have written a fugue. You introduce the subject, you'll hear it introduced in all 5 voices. The first violins, it'll start in the violas, the cellos, the second violins, and the first violins, and then finally you'll hear it in the piano. And then a fugue is like a complicated canon. Most of you are more, at least as music literate as I am, but a canon just keeps going, repeating itself, and you hear the subject over and over again, like row, row, row your boat. Except a fugue is much more complex. Instead of when you get done singing your verse, you go on and play something else. And then this gets layered. And finally, you'll hear a place, two or three places where there is no fugue subject. And then all of a sudden, it will, if we're successful with this, it'll come in. So you'll hear the fugue introduced in the violas first. And it's the difficulty playing it outside is that we don't have our best instrument, a hall, to help us. So we don't have any reverberation, and they feel like they're playing by themselves, which makes them sometimes tentative to come in. But I trust them. These are wonderful young people, remarkable. You should be grateful for them. We're grateful for them, but probably not the same way you're grateful for them. Anyway, they're going to attempt this quite difficult work, the fugue, which is the last movement of the Concerto Grosso for strings and piano by Ernst Bloch.
Why don't you just hit an A one more time? Just check your A soft.
This isn't it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. We just happened to have an encore. Composer here in the Intermountain West, Janice Cap Perry. It's a primary song. I think you'll recognize it. It's been arranged by Marshall McDonald, whose works you've heard before. Thank you.
all bow together. One, two, three. Okay? Okay. Bravo to your whole spring class. Okay?